Okay, today I'm going to be showing you how to make a teleporter in Unity. To start off, I made a cube. I resized it to 0.5 by 3 by 2. If you want to make it purple and clear like I did, you need to make a material. I called it glassy purple. This is their standard shader. Just set it to transparent here. Click here, you can pick whatever color you want, and this is how you change the transparency. I want it about here, so you can clearly see it. Now, what you're probably here for is the script. So I made this script here, and it's very, very simple. Three lines right here, don't have to touch anything else. OnTriggerEnter is a built-in function. You gotta have a collider and you name it. So I use pull. And then you get the position, well, you set the position here of the object. So coal is gonna be whatever object ends up in the teleporter. You have to set it to a new vector 3. And that takes three parameters, x, y, and z. I want it to be random. Now you can set it to whatever you want. You could put 5 here. And then whatever height you want to, and a z value, any number. But I did a random dot range between negative 10 and 10. And I don't think it's ever possible for it to hit negative 10. It might be the other way around. Maybe it's not possible for it to hit 10. It's been a while. I just want to keep its current y position since my map is flat anyway. It's not like I have to worry about hills or anything. If that's a problem for you, you might have to shoot a raycast and see exactly what height the terrain's at. And then Z value is random as well. It is a perfect square, 10 by 10, which actually means I might have too wide of a range. Anyway, we'll just forget about that. But yeah, it's pretty simple. And then you go in here. It should teleport any object with a collider. One more thing, the teleporter here, it has to have a collider and it has to be set to isTrigger true. Don't have to touch anything else. Like I said, the material is optional. I just think it's kind of cool. And then we go and play it. And it's obviously on the right here, or towards the middle technically. I walk into it. Hold on, let me zoom out so you can see the player. Player is here. You'll see the camera move. I walk into it, teleported. Walk into it, teleport. Should be. It's kind of random. It's picking a lot of the same locations for whatever reason. Well, anyway, you get the idea. That is kind of strange. How far can I actually walk out? 50? Let's change this. Negative 50. By the way, if you don't want to use a float value, you don't have to. You can just put the 50. But if you use a decimal. You need to put the F at the end to say that it's a float, which basically means it has a decimal place. We'll try this. I thought my little testing before was good enough, but. And wow. My poorly made rain. Now look at that, now we're really teleporting somewhere. So you can set it to whatever your needs are. And to show you, it can teleport anything. We will select, I'm gonna make the ball bounce first. It's just easier to set gravity just walking through there. So we made that a long time ago. Anyway, We'll go over here, select the ball, maybe pull it this way, pull it that way, and it teleported way over here. So you can literally teleport anything, as long as it has a collider, like I said. This cube, the basic cube we started with, pull it right through. Must not have a collider. Huh. Oh, that's strange. Maybe it has to have a rigid body too. That's possible. Because this has a rigid body, the player has a rigid body. We'd be teleporting the ground now that I think about it. Anyway, that's all you need to know.